Hey guys, what's up? This is Bharat. Today we're going to be unboxing and taking a first look at the new Xiaomi Mini 4K action camera. Let's quickly get started. Now the 4K action camera has not been launched in India, but it's available for a price of $110 or approximately 7,500 rupees. Now in comparison to the GoPro Hero 6, which was just recently launched for 45,000 rupees, this is definitely a much more affordable price. Now I'll leave a link to where I bought it from in the description below. It ships completely free and we were not charged any custom duties, although it may not be the same case for you guys. So packaging is pretty simplistic. We do have a bunch of information on the package itself, but it's in Chinese. So I'm going to skip through that, quickly cut through the box, open it up. The first thing inside the box is the Mini 4K action camera itself. Now it's got a matte finish and it's got this textured material wrapped around the device. I'm going to place it to the side for the time being. If I go further in, I do get some documentation. Again, it is in Chinese, so not a lot of help, but the camera should be pretty simple to operate. Also inside the box is a 1450 milliamp hour battery, which should ideally last for about 2 hours, but we found it to last only about 1.5 hours using the device continuously. You also get a charging cable, and that is essentially everything from the box of the Mi Mini 4K camera. It's time to check out the camera itself. So I'm going to get rid of the plastic packaging that's on the camera, on the lens, as well as the back of the camera. And let's quickly do a one over. So over at the front, you do have an f2.8 aperture equipped lens, and you do get a wide field of view of about 145 degrees as far as the field of view is concerned. And the lens does have a UV filter already on it, which is a good thing because most action cameras that are budget action cameras don't usually have a UV filter. Now the lens is a 7 glass element lens, so it should get you that much more detail and information. It does have inbuilt 3-axis gyroscope and 3-axis accelerometer image stabilization. So essentially a total 6-axis electronic image stabilization. It does connect via Wi-Fi or Bluetooth to your smartphone, and all you need to do is download the app that supports it. Now the chipset inside is an Ambarella chipset, the A12S75 chipset. The sensor of the camera is a Sony sensor. Now you will require a micro SD card to make this device record video or photographs, and that is not included inside the box, and you can add an up to 64 gigabyte micro SD card, which is the maximum this camera will support. Now on the bottom of the device, if you open the sliding door, you get the battery compartment along with the micro SD card slot. And over at the left of the device is the USB port. Now this can be used to charge up the device with the battery inside, and also to transfer the data from the camera to your PC or laptop or even your smartphone. Now over at the top is a single button. Now this button is also used for powering on and powering off your camera, and also to quickly initiate the camera shutter. As far as recording modes are concerned, the camera can record 4K video at up to 30 frames per second and slow-mo video at up to 200 frames per second, and that'll be on 720p. The video quality from the camera is pretty good as far as 4K video is concerned. So this is 30p video upscaled to 4K 60p to match with our video. So you'll see that video quality is pretty good for a camera that only costs 7,500 rupees or about $110. Now, as far as images are concerned, also you will get 8.3 megapixel, which is roughly 4K as far as resolution is concerned. So that is the maximum resolution that you get from the camera. Image quality again is pretty good. You do have a complete auto mode on this, but if you want some manual adjustments, you do get the ability to customize your ISO white balance, your metering mode, and some exposure value. But that's about it. You don't get a full manual mode and you don't get manual shooting capabilities. So you can set those things and then take your pictures if that's what you want. Now, because it uses a standard 1/4-inch tripod mount at the bottom, you can mount it to any form of GorillaPod or any other mounting capabilities that are available for cameras. And so it can be used with suction cups, with bike mounts, with all sorts of mounts. So you don't need to get specific or a particular type of mount for this. So if you do have some camera equipment that you use, some tripods, etc., this will directly fit onto that and it'll give you the kind of shots that you need. It also works flawlessly with selfie sticks, and there are certain accessories that are available for this. So a selfie stick that will allow you to click pictures using the handle of the selfie stick is available for this. I'll also drop a link to that if I can find it in the description below. Now, as far as video is concerned, there is something called 3D noise reduction on the video capability, which sort of improves the quality of the video footage and it removes graininess that you may get in low light situations. Because it has an f2.8 aperture, which is pretty good considering that it's an action camera, you might end up getting some noise in low light environments, and this camera tends to sort of remove that before it captures and saves the video on the format. So the video that you get from this camera will already have 3D noise reduction on it. Now, in overall, this camera is lightweight at 99 grams and it's fairly compact. As you can see, it fits quite easily in your hand or your pocket, and you get a whole lot of footage for a really low price. So if you are in the market looking for a action camera that'll give you instant photography capabilities and pretty decent video quality as well as photo quality, you can definitely go in for this one. If you're looking for something better in terms of photo and video quality, the GoPro Hero 6 does capture 4K at 60 frames per second, but that does cost almost 5 times more than this camera. So you can easily pick one according to your budget and see your requirements and then basically decide which one you want. That's it for this video. If you like this video, don't forget to smash that like button, hit that subscribe button, and until I see you guys next time, this has been Bharat. Have a great day.